got?
A John Doe was taken to the hospital.
Any suspects, weapons,
well,
evidence?
We do have the murder weapon.
Okay.
The murder weapon we believe is this.
Let's see this. Let's see if I can get my knife. Really? Got the skull print and everything. Let's get this to evidence.
Yeah, okay. Not bad. Are you sure about that?
Yeah, alright.
This shit, let's see. Our John Doe, it's Isaac Newton. He doesn't remember anything.
Out here in the field, I fought for my meals. I get my back into my business.
Have you found anything?
The computer is just analyzing it right now.
So, what injuries did Newton suffer exactly?
We got the patient file back from the hospital. Basically, Newton got a concussion. Here's how it happened. Basically, the apple hit Newton on the head. And when the apple came into contact with the skull accelerated force and experienced Newton's second law of motion. When unbalanced force acts upon an object, the object will accelerate forward. Then, because of Newton's first law of motion, the brain has inertia, because an object will continue at the same velocity, in this case zero, unless an unbalanced force is acted upon it. So the brain stays still and the skull accelerates forward, because the brain has inertia because of its mass. And then, since the skull moved forward and the brain did not, the brain is jarred around inside the skull, and it contacts the back of the skull, which caused the concussion and caused the memory loss in Newton. So, that's why he can't remember anything.
Trace the sample back to Africa.
Let's go get him. I got this. We got him! It's the time, Ginger.
We have you for unlicensed time travel and attempted murder. What do you have to say for yourself? Where did you take the booklet? I'll never tell you where the booklet is.
Alphonse, this is going nowhere. You better start talking now, or I'll have to hand you over to the interrogation unit, and they use torture methods.
We stole a top-secret time machine, went back in time to kill Newton and take his physics note so that we could rule the world with an iron fist. I'll need protection. We can arrange that, but only if you start cooperating now. I'm not telling you anything. Fine, I'll tell you. The booklet, it's at 1234 Chestnut Way.
Good, don't hit me.
Thank you for your cooperation. We got what we needed.
Let's go. Stay in your cell. Is this the spot?
Yep. 1234 Chestnut Way.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna find it. Don't worry. I got it. I'm coming back to the lab. So, according to Newton's calculations, there's only one way for him to regain his memory, and that's by relearning his own laws. So, this is the third law. So, remember when we were firing our guns that one time? There's one of our guns. When we fire our guns, it basically caused an explosion in the cartridge of this bullet, which launches the bullet out of the gun. Basically, this formula means that the smaller the mass, the bigger the acceleration, and the bigger the force, the bigger the acceleration, but the bigger the mass, the smaller acceleration. So the bullet is really small. The gun is much larger than the bullet. And then so Newton's third law, which is for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So basically this explosion in this cartridge of the bullet causes the same amount of force to act upon the gun and the bullet. But because the bullet's mass is really small and there's a big force, then the acceleration is big. But since the gun's mass is really big, and the force is still the same, the acceleration is much smaller. So that's why the gun doesn't go flying out of her hand. The bullet accelerates forward. You got that?
Eureka! I remember.
Anyone know what this is?
Oh, he's on a mission in ancient Egypt.
Well, I guess we saved the future once again.
Cheers, cheers to that. Out here.